What's up guys, my name is Kerry and today we are going to be doing a cold start video part 2 of my RX7. Notice that my shit's got a lot of views on that video. Like, it's not like at 150. I'm like, what the fuck? I was just, the car wasn't even tuned, the motor wasn't even broken in. All I did was turn it on during the winter. I had to jump it because the battery was dead, but now we're in Texas, so that Texas humidity started to kick up and it's getting hot. But I'm gonna do a cold start. I haven't driven the car. It's been sitting here at the shop. As you can see, it looks all shiny. I'll walk around real quick. As you can see, the car's here. I have the C-West bumper on. I just put it back on. Of course, I had a little damage. Got the new headlight covers. The engine's been tuned. We made at 453 horsepower and 9 pounds of boost because our fuel pump ran out, so that's all we can max out at. We're going to go for the good old 600s, but 450 is fine enough for the streets. As you can see, I do have an RZ or RZ, however you want to call it. I have the Kevlar seats that tilt back, cool interior, the all black interior, everything's good. I have an R Magic wing. I know there's a lot of people always ask about this wing. It's not a Mazda speed, it's completely different. It's an R Magic version 1, which I got from their, it was originally pink. I got it from the R Magic themselves. They had it in one of their demo cars or one of their project cars. And of course the REMMEA rear diffuser, stock Azenki tail lights, little tow hook, the Rega Masters. Now a lot of people always ask me what size are these Rega Masters. These are 17 by 9 plus 18. I'm running a 255 40 17 Kenda KR20 street tire on the rear, and on the front I have a 235 40 17 in order to hit full lock without having any rubbing issues. I am on the, what am I rolling on, M Sport side skirts, of course all the goodies. Last time I didn't have the tow hook, not the tow hook, the strut bar on it. Tow hook in the front, strut bar, C-West, all the good shit, BBK, ready big brakes, and yeah. Here, let me turn off the car. Baby girl's kind of loud. So a lot of people pointed out what's all been done to it. So this engine was built by Maple Racing in Houston, Texas. And his name is James Belair of Maple Racing. So what he did, previously the rear rotor went out, so we got a new rotor housing, got everything cleaned up, everything new from Mazda. It's a large street port half Bridgeport for the cool rotary sounds that makes all the magics and whistles and all the magic happen. Yeah, that's what I meant. So yes, everybody always asks like, why is your battery in the front? Well, that's what the fucking relocator kit that came with the car was for. This, I don't want to have the battery in the back. I don't like having the battery in the back. I don't like having the battery inside the car. I'll have it in the trunk, but it's already there. Why change it? We added a catch can. Now, the one thing that I did not upgrade, and I wish I could have upgraded, was this from Elite Rotary Shop. So a little background about myself. My name is Kerry. I am an importer. I've lived in Japan for about 9 months to a year. I still have an apartment over there, but due to the whole coronavirus and all that bullshit, I haven't been able to go back. So I've been doing everything remotely. And mostly we focused on three-piece wheels. And so that's most of our bread and butter right here. As you can see, right now we're a little low. We're working on next container. We'll have more wheels. But if you want to check us out or support the channel or follow us, give us a like on Instagram, Keisjdmauto, K-E-I-S-J-D-M-Auto. And if you notice, this is our secondary shop project, our AE86 build, which my partner is currently working on, but he's working on a customer's truck. So this is gonna be beam swap. It's gonna be fully stripped, fully looking good. We have a full TRD wide body kit for this car, which is right here. We were able to source in Japan. And so we just need to find the Levine front bumper. We'll get the Levine front bumper and probably the next shipment or the second shipment. We had some cool wheels for it. We don't know how wide we're gonna go. We're gonna go 15 by 9, 15 by 10. Depends on what it is. With some deep offset wheels. The car doesn't look immaculate yet, but all the parts are there. The interior is there. All the good stuff is here. Of course, I don't know. We wanted to do ITBs, but get rid of this ugly ass dual stage plenum intake manifold. So we have some Rayburg headlights, the ECU, the shifters. So it's a 6-speed, and here, you check this out. Our Link Monsoon ECU. We have the whole wiring harnesses. New parts, brake master cylinder, oil relocator kit, a lot of stuff. Oil coolers. You see there's a valve cover. But yeah. So we're probably gonna do this every weekly. Probably make a video or on our YouTube channel, add stuff to it. The RX7's got about to be sold, so that won't be here anymore. We'll put our focus back on the AE86. And then of course, we have this other VIP build here, right here. It's, I probably should have mentioned that. It is a Lexus LS460L, so it's the big body. Here, I'll show you a cool thing. So it's Lexus 460L. It's the air ride suspension. Of course, it's 2007. It's got all the bells and whistles. Pop that open up. Oh, but check this out. Excuse me, sir. Oh, okay. As you can see, it's pretty comfortable back here. And then you'd have, of course, you have your chauffeur close the door on you and then open the door. Of course, you can't get out this motherfucker once the door's closed, because you have to open the front door in order to open up the back door.